I'm Dr. Tanya Harrison, and I call myself a professional Martian because over the past decade, I've worked in science and mission operations for the Opportunity, Curiosity, and Perseverance rovers and the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter for NASA. But I'm also a geologist. My background is I have a Ph.D. in geology with a specialization in planetary science and exploration. This means that I specialize in the geology of Mars, but in order to understand the geology of another planet, we have to understand it here on Earth. So I work on a lot of different types of geology using things like satellite imagery to try and look at the shapes of stuff on the surface of planets to understand what the history was of a particular area. We call this geomorphology. My specialties are in things like impact craters, landslides, volcanism, and what we call the cryosphere. So anything that has to do with ice, glaciers, snow, things like that. So I study those things in the Canadian Arctic as an analog for things that we see on Mars. On Mars, I worked in mission operations for the cameras aboard the missions I mentioned earlier, which meant that I got to see all of the planet every single day, and I would look at those pictures from the standpoint of a geologist to see what they might tell us about the history of Mars, what implications that might have for life on Mars, and how Mars has changed over time to go from this planet that used to be very Earth-like, with lakes and oceans and rain and a thicker atmosphere, to this cold polar desert that we see today that is more harsh than even Antarctica in wintertime here on the Earth. Right now, I currently work for a commercial Earth observation company called Planet Labs, which builds and operates the largest fleet of Earth imaging satellites that are currently orbiting our planet. We image the entire landmass of the Earth every single day to look for change, and then to make that change visible, accessible, and actionable. So we look at everything from food security around the world by looking at how crops are changing and how healthy they are over time, to the impacts of climate change around the world. And we want to try to make it so that folks can take action on the things that they're seeing to try to protect human lives, save money, save the economy, and make life better for everyone on Earth. So even though I've spent a lot of my life on Mars, more recently I've come back home to Earth for the things that I do on a day-to-day basis, but my heart will always be on the red planet. Ever since the tiny Sojourner rover got there in 1997, it just enamored me, and I've been in love with the red planet ever since. So I can talk about any terrestrial planet, really, because when we study geology here on Earth, like I said, we take that and apply it to other rocky planets in the solar system. And something that we see on, say, Mercury or Pluto, we have to be able to understand how that formed by looking at how things have formed here on the Earth. So planetary science is kind of a cool catch-all to understand all the planets in our solar system, and maybe beyond.